to find out all about the making of the video to go with it, and almost, would you believe, ended up starring in it.
I'm here at a top secret location for the video shoot of what's being described as Hearsay's comeback single. Now, the word is it's going to be a massive hit, but of course, in the world of pop, nothing is ever pure and simple.
Following their meteoric rise to pop stardom, Hearsay's career has been a roller coaster ride. From the chart-topping, record-breaking highs to the lows of losing an original member of the band. But now they're back with a new lineup, a new single, and a new video.
When they told me I was going to go behind the scenes at a Hearsay video shoot, I thought I would be on a yacht in the Bahamas. We're in an old town hall in the east end of London. Suzanne, whose idea was this?
Well, it wasn't mine. Don't blame this on me.
We wanted to go for something a little bit cooler, a little bit sexier than our other videos.
So we filmed it in metal.
it's just basically just about us kind of chilling out.
So is there a little story to the video? Johnny, can we see a little sequence?
There isn't really a story to it though, is it?
Well, Myleene gets down and...
Myleene's a little bit of, you know...
Yeah. Jiggy jiggy.
About that, Myleene.
Not true, whatever Richard's quality is not true.
I heard you get to snog a very attractive hunk in this video.
Yeah, that's true. I thought, well, a bit out of practice, so I thought I'd get it in on the video.
So your job actually doubles as a dating service.
Exactly.
Your first album was a massive hit, obviously, and the second one didn't quite reach those sorts of dizzy heights. Did that hurt you?
No, not at all. I mean, you know, you can never top the initial hit of what Hearsay was about. You know, we had a 14-week series as promotion for a band. And then the second album still sold over 200,000 copies. Now, that's not bad at all. But because it wasn't as big as the 1.2 million albums, they go, oh, well, they're rubbish, they must be over. But it was a decent album and our fans bought it. And, you know, the support's still there.
And after the departure of Kym, has the arrival of new band member Johnny changed anything?
When you get a new person in, it does change the dynamic. Obviously, Johnny's got his own musical instruments.
Cue the banjo.
He's got his own musical influences, you know, and he brings that to the group, and he brings his talent to the group as well, so it does change.
But the girls have discovered some downsides to a new male-dominated Hearsay.
So you're not having to organise your filming around the World Cup or anything now?
We are having to organise our filming around the World Cup. In fact, the boys have done no filming so far. We're halfway into the day.
We're only doing this because we're in half time.
Charming. But it's not all about football. There's hard work too.
It's an exclusive in the video. We have a dance break in it, which has been put into the track. So it does show off where we've come from pure and simple to now, that we are doing a lot more dancing, obviously because we want to change it around because we've got a new member in. So that's going to be coming up later, so you'll hear us all going...
And to find out just how exhausting it is, my producer volunteered me to learn the routine.
What's your own trousers now? Let's do it again.
Ooh, what's going on?
This is the bit where you put 3 hours later.
There is. Please log on to the Small Town Gardens website.
Welcome back. Now, they were the first British group to top the single and album charts at the same time with their debut release. Everything looked pure and simple for the Poptastic Five. What's the funny?
I'm naive. It was reflection time.
You can look back on it and think, should I or shouldn't I?
We think should, but it's like, it's really cool that we've
it's got weird,
a new group sitting here, right. And it's all changed and it's all positive now.
We'll get to it. But when Kym Marsh said sensationally for the group, it looked like Hearsay were going to be just that. The press said they were finished, but they're back.
Ta-ta-ta.
With a new singer and a new song. Welcome Danny, Myleene, Suzanne, Noel, and newcomer
Johnny!
Hey, right.
Hello.
Is this your first appearance live?
It is the first live.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well,
so
you've got to say like,
oh,
well, then.
Hello, Mom.
Well, how's it been for you then?
Wicked.
Right?
Great. We've had a wicked 5 months.
Give us the facts. When did 5 months?
Nearly 5 months. Yes.
But you look very at home already.
Yeah, I am. Dude, my four mates now. It's great.
Your family.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So what's happened in the 5 months?
Well, what hasn't happened? Mm. We went away, started recording, got loads of wicked new stuff. Working on dance routines, working on everything, and working on styling. Got it. And we're back.
Yeah. Yeah. You're back. This
How
is
much
it.
Hard work do you have to put? Because I was watching you rehearsing earlier. And those dance routines, I mean, I would be all... I wouldn't remember the first two bits of it. Does it... Is it... It looks so effortless now, but do you have to really work hard at it?
Yeah, definitely. Hours and hours and hours. yeah, we spent, like, a couple of weeks on the new routine and stuff. But it's something that we haven't really had the opportunity to do before because everything was so quick last year.
Yeah.
And we work 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, just running around all over the country. Mm-hmm. And it's been nice to kind of take a step back, think about what we achieved and what we're planning to achieve, and just get the package complete.
It makes it been a hell of a shock. I mean, from you know pretty much unknowns, and then suddenly, bang! You know, headlines and attention and
it was literally overnight, wasn't it?
Yeah, I don't think it's been ever. sorry, darling. But I don't think you can ever prepare yourself for that. I don't think you can ever do it, and that's why we were laughing at the clip,
right?
Because it's that naivety, you just walk into it and you think, you know, I'd do anything to do this, and all of a sudden you kind of make sacrifices that you never thought would happen. But now in reflection, it's kind of good to look back and kind of add a bit of knowledge and go, well, you know, we're just enjoying it now and forget
I mean, even
that
looked pretty slick to me. But look, we've got a clip now of your new single, so let's have a look.
This is a Dookie first as well. Describe what you were and describe what you are now.
Good question. I think when we first came into it, you know, you're excited, you're starry-eyed, but we've still got the determination, but also we've got the knowledge behind us.
Mm-hmm.
And we realise who we can and can't trust, and that drives us on to create, you know, to create something bigger.
The good thing is that having the time off has made us be able to sit down and think about exactly what actually happened to us within that year.
Because although
we knew, we knew what was happening, because we was just so working 24/7, we didn't have time to sit down and think, oh God, we've just done the Brit Awards.
Yeah.
And only now we've sat down and gone, what an amazing year we had. And there's more of that to come now.
There's days when you live literally three lifetime experiences in one day, and you don't even get a chance to reflect on that.
What made you decide to get a fifth member? Because it's not like you were called five or whatever, or S Club 7 as they were.
We always saw Hearsay as a five, and because of we was given such a big opportunity, we obviously wanted to give somebody else an opportunity we could have. And when we came to the auditions, Johnny was the best person for that job.
And if you look at the Spice Girls and take that and other bands, you've got to learn from it. Every time I saw them, you don't concentrate on the four, you concentrate on the gap. And then you're like a wounded animal, there's always going to be something missing.
So was it a management decision or your decision?
We decided. Right. Many
I don't think too many people tell this lot what to do.
Looking back, obviously heavily criticised for the auditions, were they a good idea? Because we all know you knew Johnny. I mean, nobody would say anything if you just go on and say, well, look, we know Johnny's just going to come in. But the fact that you went down that road, looking back, do you wish you hadn't have done it?
What, the auditions?
Yeah.
Oh, no, it was definitely the right decision. We wanted to give an opportunity to somebody else, basically, at the end of the day, because that's where we came from. We went to an audition and queued up like everybody else, and then all of a sudden we had this opportunity and we were there. Yeah. But we wanted to do that with someone else, so we thought we'd do an open audition, so it wasn't kind of nepotism in any way. It wasn't our friend or someone, you know, like the producer who knows this person. So it was good that Johnny came along and queued up like the rest, and he was there, and then they did say it was a fix and all that, but at the end of the day, it just wasn't a fix. Mm-hmm. I mean, he had danced for us before.
You were the best man for the job.
Yeah,
Johnny.
He was.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, it's funny because, like you said, you knew Johnny. I actually didn't know him. I knew to say hello to. He was literally, I was one of 15 dancers, so it sort of took it away from me a little bit because I did queue up in the rain and then did spend the 2 days wondering, oh, am I going to get through this round? Am I going to get through that round? Mm. And then spend the night laying in bed going, what's going to happen?
Yeah.
So it's, that was really bad for us, really.
We've got some emails.
Yeah,
here.
Yeah, I got my badges.
Jody from North London. I love Noel, and he has a fab body. I bet he looks great with no clothes on. Does he?
Very
can you just turn to the side? Let's see this hair thing. What's going on there?
I think we all just decided to take it up a level and start looking like pop stars.
Some more than others.
In answer to Jodie's question, we have this picture.
No!
Brilliant!
Yeah.
That is brilliant!
You like that?
Oh, thank you very much. My mum's watching.
Oh, we've got you now. Right, next email.
Brad.
What's the best thing about being famous? From Brad in Nottingham. Who wants to take that?
I think the best thing about being famous is it is a 1 in a million chance. And I think it even proved it that even though whatever's said in the press, whatever people think of our lifestyle or anything, people still queued up to be part of it. So we don't take a single day for granted. It's a great opportunity and it's a dream job. So.
And having your own stylist and makeup artist, so nothing
it does
do that,
help.
Do you think that televised talent shows are the best way to break into music? And what do you think of Will and Gareth? Dawn from Newcastle.
Television talent shows are the best thing. Years ago, you used to have New Faces Opportunity Knocks and people had a chance for British talent to shine. Will and Gareth are really good. I think they epitomised. They're there. They're at the front and it's good, do you know what I mean? They came from the street and they're there.
They're doing Pop Stars 2 at the moment, aren't they?
They're doing
all the auditions all
just
over.
Just gives people a fair chance because a lot of it is to do with nepotism.
Well, just gives them a chance.
And there's so much talent.
And what
out
I would say
as well
is that you usually find that the best thing about these talent shows is that people get seen, and with, I think, the last couple of talent shows through the door. So you have to be careful of that as well. And I think if you're going to show talent, show British talent and don't show somebody being
nasty.
When's the single out?
August the 5th.
Talking of talent, Danny, you're obviously last in the queue with the stylist.
I know what he's going to show.
This is the book here. This is Danny.
Oh, yeah.
A dilemma of what to wear. Perhaps you can help me make up my mind.
It's nice because I managed to get my Oxton t-shirt on, and that's where I'm from, Oxton, so it's in the book as well, so that's cool.
Well, we thought we'd help you out here, Danny.
Right,
We've got Johnny.
We have our very own stylist.
And we've got some...
Mr. John Scott.
He's got his rather like... They're nice. Actually, I've got a pair like that.
Have you? Well, we're a bit concerned about Johnny because he's not in the book, so I've got a pair for you as well.
Fabulous.
We've got
a pair
for you.
Well, it's lovely to meet you, and you're back a week Monday going to perform the single for us. Best of luck with it. It's very catchy. I was listening to the rehearsal. Very catchy.
Thanks for supporting us. Thank you. All the guys out there. Thanks to all our fans.
Thanks a lot.
Good to see you again. Now, like hearsay, lots of stars have found fame thanks to TV.